two boxes of the same type of DCMT, yada 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 inserts. Forget the number, they're small. This one cost me €4 and this one €12. I actually used a coupon, so I got them a little cheaper, but roughly speaking, these are 3 times as expensive as these, probably anywhere in this world, whatever currency you use. As you can see, both of these come in an unmarked red box, and both are, according to the seller's website, made from the same type of carbide, something called YBC251. And the shape of the chip breaker on these inserts also looks exactly the same. So what's the difference, I hear you ask? Although the better question might be, what justifies the price difference? It must be in the color or the coating that's on these inserts. The gold colored inserts are probably titanium nitrate coated, or TIN, and that's one of the earlier types of coating. It helps with the wear of the insert at high temperatures, and well, basically it makes the insert or whatever tool more slippery. Lots of information about these type of inserts can be found anywhere on the internet. Now these blue inserts, they are called blue nano inserts, or the coating is blue nano. It is supposed to help with the turning of harder materials. I couldn't find much on the internet about these blue nano colored inserts, so I have decided to compete them against the gold colored ones in some sort of pseudo scientific experiment designed to advance the human knowledge and waste your time and fill up the internet. But first, let's meet the contestants and check them out under the microscope. Meet Mr. Gold. He's maybe a little bit rough around the edges and wearing a gold colored suit. I think he looks a bit like a sugar coated golden donut, although maybe not as round. Anyway, good luck to Mr. Gold, and say hello to Mr. Blue, the multicolored fancy boy. He is dark blue near the middle and lighter in color near the tip, where all the action is going to happen. It's almost like he's wearing his blue coat inside out. Maybe he ran out of budget. Paint can be very expensive. But apparently there was enough budget for some gold details near the tip. Anyway, good luck to you too, Mr. Blue. Meet tonight's judge, or a test piece. I actually used this before on a blue nano insert, and it won. The plan for tonight's test is simple. Best of three facing cuts of increased depth at the same speed. The one who survives the longest is the winner. But first I'm going to drill a hole through here so I can take facing cuts in both directions. First contestant for tonight. So, this first round, I'm going to cut things dry The maximum speed of this lathe is 680 RPM, and that is what I'm going to use for this test. And that's touch off. I just set the top slide dial to zero, and now I'm dialing in about 500ths of a cut. To be honest, I'm not really sure about the graduations on this dial, but as long as I treat both inserts in the same way, it's fine. Here we go. Wow, that's seriously smooth. That's a mirror-like finish. Lovely. Let's double the cut on the return pass. Now taking a bit of a beating from the cross drilled holes. That was still very easy. So we had 5, 10, and now it's time for 1500. 5, 10, 15. Alright. Still a great finish. All right, 20 on the return pass. Still very nice. All right, 25, 10, 15. 20, 25. I'm moving the camera back because it's too much in my way at its current location. 25. The finish isn't as nice, but let's try a 30 as well. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and that's probably the maximum this lathe can handle. There seems to be a flaw in my test plan. I think the insert isn't removing enough material and is starting to rub on the underside. I guess I better start over again to keep things fair and equal. But let's check out this insert under the microscope first, see what kind of damage it did. And this is what Mr. Gold looks like after a little bit of action. It's already missing a chunk, but you cannot blame Mr. Gold for that, because it was clearly rubbing on the underside of the insert. as you can see by the coating that has been worn away. Focus. The other way. I'm too close. There it is. I think it was already rubbing on the underside of the insert, the previous return pass, and it has worn a groove inside the insert. Alright, no more return passes. And this here is Mr. Gold 2.0. Let's quickly check him out. Focus. Okay, that's good. The other side. Also good. Back to the lathe. Let's forget everything we did so far and start over with Mr. Blue. And this is going to be the 500th of a millimeter cut. No cut on the return. Ten hundredths. Oh, beautiful. 15. Still perfect. I don't think I've ever seen such a great finish. Not on the Scriptonian. 20. A little bit of cheddar. Still very nice. 25. Again with the cheddar. Finish is getting worse near the center. Probably where the cheddar was. 30. And that's probably the maximum this lathe can handle. Chips are getting a little bit cold color. And there's the cheddar again. Similar result. I could try 35, but if the cheddar gets worse, it might cause the insert to break, and that would influence the test unfairly. Let's try another one at 30. I try to keep the same feed rate, and that seemed to help with the cheddar. Let's try 30 again. It's getting warm now. Surface finish is still very good for Scriptonium. Let's switch to Mr. Gold 2, run it through the same test, and then compare the results under the microscope. I did not move the tool bit when switching to Mr. Gold 2.0, and if I want to keep everything fair, I should also wait till this test piece has a cool down. A little brake cleaner might speed things up. And now it's time for Mr. Gold 2.0 to shine. And as before, let's start with 0.05 mm cut. Okay, very nice, very acceptable. 10. And 20. Nice. Dialing in 25. And now 30. I'm starting to see some concentric circles in the surface finish, but it still feels very nice. Let's take two more cuts at 30 and then compare. And the last cut. No more chatter. Did you notice that? Maybe because the workpiece is getting shorter. Less overhang, less chatter. And it is getting hot again. Probably about the same temperature as when testing with Mr. Blue. Alright, let's compare the result under the microscope. And here is Mr. Blue after its test run. It looks like there are a few pieces missing there. Here it is again, after I try to clean it up. There might be a piece missing on the right side of the tip. It's actually a bit hard to see. Let's flip it over and refocus. Yeah, there's definitely something missing. Although it was still cutting fine. I think the coating is gone. The layer of coating. It might have come off. Okay. Let's have a look at Mr. Gold 2.0. Also some chips left on the tip. I just licked a insert. That's new. Cannot say I liked it. That might be the exact same result. Yeah. There might be some welding going on there. It's hard to see. Well, this round looks to be a draw. I cannot declare a winner here. So that's 1-1. I guess it's pretty pointless to do the same thing again, so I will now use the good side of the insert and start cutting it 0.3 millimeter and see how long it lasts. Hopefully I will have a result before I run out of test piece. But first we need to wait till I have recharged the battery. It's a couple of days later and I'm getting ready to continue my highly scientific experiment. But first I want to replace this clamp to give you guys a better view at the action. I've done some editing and I have decided to continue using the same inserts and see if I can break them with a heavier cut than 0.3 millimeter. Hopefully the lathe can handle it, but we will see. Mr. Blue is back in the holder here, and let's start the day with another 0.3 millimeter cut. Looks like I moved the tool bit a bit when I exchanged the clamp. Let's use a little bit of oil this time. 0.3 millimeter. No chatter, that's good. I don't know. That probably wasn't the right thing to do. 10, 20, 30, 35. Let's just try it. It's getting very hard to turn the cross line. Finish is a bit rough, so I bet that insert is gone. Probably my fault when I dragged it over the surface. Since I made a stupid mistake, this result is no longer valid, but we can have a look at the insert under the microscope. And then I will switch to new pointy bits. Here is Mr. Blue, after I made that mistake and dragged the insert over the surface while the lathe wasn't spinning. It actually looks better than I thought it would. I think a little bit of the workpiece got welded to the cutting edge. Let's check the side. Yeah, that edge has come up a bit and is now wider, not as sharp. I actually gave Mr. Gold 2.0 the same treatment, and this is how it looks now. A very similar result. There's also some material welded to the cutting edge, although the tip might also be gone. There's some curatoring there. Let's have a look at the side. Yeah, there's definitely a chunk missing on the corner, on the tip. Alright, interesting. Let's continue with round two, using the unused sides of these inserts.
I think you can call this round two. This is the other side of Mr. Gold 2.0, and I'm starting with 3/10 of a millimeter cuts. Let's see how long it lasts. For round two, I'm using a bit of oil. Hot chips, although they cool quickly. Very nice finish. Let's take a few more cuts at the same depth. Cut number four, also 3/10. I gotta drill those holes a little deeper. Cut number eight. Cool. Last cut, because I'm getting bored. Alright, that was 10 cuts, and I'm pretty sure it will do a few more, but I gotta drill out those holes. This one is almost gone. And then I will take 10 more cuts with Mr. Blue.
That's it. It won't go any deeper. What a mess. But at least now I can continue with my very important scientific work.
Well, let's continue this nonsense with Mr. Blue. See if he can also take 10 of those 0.3 of a millimeter cuts. Bit of loop to keep things fair. Here we go. Chatter. Very nice, very similar. Cut number two, same depth. Chatter again. Not for long, but still. Cut number five, same depth. Finish is still very nice. Now I'm going to compare it with the other one.
All right, I'm back at the microscope. Let's see how these inserts held up after a similar beating. First, the other side of Mr. Gold 2.0, and that definitely is a little bit damaged on where the cutting action is. It almost looks cracked. Let's lay it on its side. Coating missing. Zooming out. Yep. There are a few chunks missing. And that's my nail. Yep. Yeah, there is some damage, but it was still cutting fine. And it looks a lot better than during the first test. That's the first round. Alright, moving on to Mr. Blue. That looks better than Mr. Gold. Although the cutting edge looks thicker, some material might have welded itself to the edge. And now on the side, that looks a bit dark. Zooming out, the edge also looks higher here. It isn't perfect anymore, but it held up better than Mr. Gold. And just like Mr. Gold, this one was also still cutting fine. I think I should continue testing if I want to come to any scientific conclusion. But I'm bored. And you guys must have moved on to something better. Besides, I want a cup of tea. Personally, I'm pretty much convinced that these blue nano inserts are not worth the extra cost. But you should make up your own mind. It's your money. And if you buy them through my affiliated links, It's more money for me. All right, I had enough of this. I'm out of here. Till next time.